been God all the way. So I'm really excited.
We love Babcock.
We love Babcock.
This is just the beginning.
Shining with grace.
Young and determined, full of excitement, we came to a place where we revered and could not wait to explore. The great and so much talked about university. A university that produces shining stars. The famous Babcock University. We saw its glorious grandeur. We saw its toils. We saw its tough times. And we saw the sweet moments. How can we ever forget? Memorable and defining, shall it ever be called?
I welcome you to this very important meeting. Holding here in the Senior Vice President's office for the inaugural session or inauguration of the Electoral Committee of 2018-2019.
Welcome to this very important meeting. What your colleagues asked you to do for them is a very important and solemn assignment. Conduct an election that is to be adjourned fair, credible, as transparent as possible.
The Phoenix 2019 class has been a success story. From the inception, it has not been very easy to organize the students. Over 2,300 and some fraction students with my colleague, Dr. Adejumo, when we started. Getting them together for the elections, for the movement around to make sure they read their manifesto was not easy at all. But one thing I noticed, which is very glaring, when you talk about Phoenix 2019 graduating class. They're intentional, they are consistent, they are focused.
Since my 200 level, I've been able to perform musically in almost all the worship centers and in other places here on campus.
I have a passion for the service of fellow men.
It's to see the well-being of all members of graduating class, which include the students and also the staffs and also the coordinators.
I want to also ensure that we have like the best time of our lives by organizing several activities that might interest the graduating class.
Anybody can run for the post of financial secretary. For the fact that that's my specialty, that makes a whole lot of difference.
I want to be able to give back to the school as well as serve as a medium of communication between the final year graduating students as well as the school.
Public health is about improving people's health.
and to improve people's health, we deal with promoting and prevention.
BABCOCK gives everyone an opportunity to present themselves or to give their best, to serve in their best capabilities. And I see the president as a way for me to give my best to my graduating class.
I want to build up a mechanism so that after leaving school, we still have something to do together.
My drive for the purpose of the president of graduating class is to bring every graduating student together, to make the class compact, and to bring us to the desired end.
I know I'm accountable, I'm responsible, coordinate, and also make sure that our meetings go on well.
A support system in the fact that I'll help them out, advise, find out information where necessary, talk to them, and just help everybody graduate.
Marshalling resources to ensure maximum use for the best project we can ever have on the Peru campus.
I desire to express my creativity and logical ability in working with the other members of the executive of the graduating class.
I have a reputation of having good heart.
And the class project that we bring out is being seen from start to finish and is being done as planned.
One should be accountable for everything. Like, I should be accountable for it. It's all about integrity.
Thank you for coming. Love you.
During my course of work, I also saw that in times we have to keep to time because timing affects most of the things, and that's what I really learned, that one, procrastination is actually a killer of time.
I have learned to work with people, teamwork, very key, and I think the position of General Secretary for the graduating class has prepared me for the rigors of life outside as some of us know it.
Simply put, I aim to make this graduation year as spectacular as possible. Thank you.
And I hope to fulfill so many duties and to give the best of my ability in the course of my duty.
My main plan is to work together with everyone in the graduation community to ensure that this graduation year is as successful and as smooth as possible.
What I seek to desire, to achieve rather, is my desire to bring the class together to make sure that every class member graduates June 2nd, 2019.
As the secretary, I would ensure that minutes are being prepared in time and memos are being circulated in time. And I will also ensure that the secretariat is closer to the people.
Well, my plan basically is to make sure that we have like the best time of our lives this last year, making sure that all the social activities that we want, which will be approved by school authority, will be, you know, into everything and all.
My aim is to put together everyone who has something to give musically.
Having me as your chaplain, we're going to be interceding on your behalf, we'll pray on your behalf, making sure that all the problems that are going to stop your graduation, God will remove them.
Let us come together to see how we can do this, but this cannot happen if you don't vote for me.
A vote for me is a vote for your welfare.
I will give you the best. All of you will be informed on campus. No one will be left out. I need your support because you are that important.
Whatever the class picks and decides to do, that will bring it to the letter.
I believe in leaving a legacy that will be awe-inspiring. I intend to oversee the safety and the accuracy of all the treasures of the 2019 graduating class.
So, if I say I will properly ensure that your funds are transparent, I know what I'm saying.
I am a team member. I sacrifice for this team. I defer to this team because at the end of the day, the team, not the individual, is the ultimate champion. Thank you.
I make life easy for all those who work with me by creating an environment so friendly everyone is allowed to express their personality.
And I would also ensure that the secretariat will be very close to the people.
So a vote for me is a vote for unity, because unity starts with each and every one of you.
What I say is what I'm going to do. When I set goals, I achieve them.
Of course, our ultimate goal is to make sure that every person in this class will match come June 2nd, 2019.
Do we want beautiful activities to be allowed? If I'm elected, I will ensure that your needs are met.
If you vote for me, all the information you need, you get to this campus as well.
Being in BABCOCK for 4 or 5 years, we actually want to leave. Dropping something that will forever be remembered for.
We work together. I said work together. Thank you very much.
Leadership is not in position, but it's an action.
No. And I promise to be transparent, accountable, and trustworthy.
I intend to oversee your financial activities with transparency, integrity, transparency, and
please, I need you guys to vote for me because at the end of the day, we are all team members. When you chase after perfection, you achieve excellence. Excellence is my watchword.
I promise to strengthen this association and to lift us up from the position of goodwill to the position of prominence.
I will put your needs to the forefront. What you say, I will fear. Your ideas, I will share. And so I want to make you know that the guys on the Cairo campus, they have inspection work. And because they have inspection work, it means that we're going to sit for it and make sure that we fix our work for you.
We have to do better. So that's a huge, huge work to get done. But by the grace of God, once those who are going to become the officials become the officials, the Lord will strengthen you and He'll grant you the grace to persevere. And to the rest of us, it's not going to be easy, so let's work with them.
Thank you very much.
Pulled 150, while Ophelia Uchechukwu Ndoka polled 196. Ofili Uchechukwu Ndoka is hereby returned as the president 2018-2019 graduating class.
I would say that it has made me understand that working with people is a skill that needs to be developed. I would say that it has made me understand there should be proof for every transaction that should be given. I would say that transparency, accountability, and integrity is a key core value of every person in life.
Well, the experience has been amazing. I met a new family, the executives, the sponsor and the co-sponsors. The experience has been very wonderful, though stressful, but it was worth it at the end of the day.
You're wonderful. Those that voted, you're wonderful. Those that did not vote, you're wonderful. All agents that were there at the election will attest that it was free and fair. I am Pastor Ike, and this is Dr. Esther Dejumo. Both of us are co-sponsors to graduating class 2018-2019. The sponsor of the class is Dr. Aaron Ogundewi. That is the sponsor of the graduating class 2018-2019. You elected a president for yourself. I invite the president of the graduating class to please come. Mr. Ofili is your president.
Has really brought out something in me that I knew it was there, but I never really had the courage to explore it before. I've been very tenacious these past few months, and I say, yeah, I'm happy of the kind. I'm happy of who I am now. I'm better off.
The vice president has, would I say, impacted me greatly. It has instilled me with patience that I didn't even know I had. It has shown me how to work with other people. It has also enhanced some abilities like tolerance. My tolerance level, it has greatly increased. And I mean, it's not over yet, but I'm still learning. And I'm really happy that this journey has been a very fruitful one.
Well, it made me understand the idea of protecting the minority. So, like, obviously we have to protect the majority, the vote of the majority or the concerns of the majority, but we also need to protect the views and the concerns of the minority, because as a small campus, our needs will definitely be different from that of the main campus.
My name is Ogechi Okonkwo, and I'm proposing a name for the graduating class. The name I'm proposing for the 2019 graduating class is Phoenix Graduating Class. The Phoenix, with its great beauty, creates intent, excitement, and endless inspiration. The Phoenix rises above all adversity, all troubles, all trials and tribulations. It shines with God's light.
So it's said to be a bird that lived in Arabia, okay? Had linkage with that of sun god worship of the Egyptians. So do you think that it would be very good to accept this in this kind of environment?
There are a lot of things that are myths. I know that it may not be real, but we're looking at it as a symbol. God used wind as a symbol for the Holy Spirit. So we're not taking it as a myth, because we know it isn't real. But we're taking it as a symbol for what we are, for we are God's fire burning with his grace.
And my name is Ugoji Solomon Wisdom. I am suggesting Iroko graduating class. The Iroko tree represents wholeness, reliability, elegance, security, healing, home, grounding, foundation, stability, warmth, and honesty.
Iroko. If you are for Phoenix, raise your hands, we count. Phoenix is returned as winner.
You master the art of problem solving.
So now the correct pronunciation of the word oil is oil.
So planning is the most important thing. Plan. Maybe that word multicultural environment was what's on the CV. What will you do now? You will take it and put it there.
You have enough battles to fight. Choose your battle wisely.
Thank you very much. All right, for the next class, we have a question.
There are a couple of things that can make people not be conscious. So one of them is ego.
Etiquette refers to those behaviors, acts, or guidelines when relating with people.
We have social and business etiquette. There's dining etiquette. Etiquette is wide, but I'm just narrowing it down to social and business. So differences between the two.
There are so many things you can do when you have this digital skill. So you can see that going online is not just chatting. There are so many things that organizations are looking for. And they're looking for young men and women like you that will help them make it happen. Google is empowering people. That for you to engage people properly in the online space, you need the right skill.
Impacted me positively because I learned a whole lot of things. I learned teamwork, I learned that inner peace, okay, in the sense that it's not every time that you get what you want and that you just have to not be angry about certain things in life.
Papa baby.
Started out, you know, a bit shaky, but now at this point, people are really jumping around. Come out to like, it's actually, it's quite interesting.
Wow, I'm so excited. I really appreciate the turnout. It's really been great.
And everybody is alive, so we are enjoying it.
Great, great, wonderful, wonderful. These kids are just...
Nothing will stop June seconds from us in Jesus' name.
Excited today because it's the last rally of course as graduating class members. We'll be right back.
I mean, looking at what's happening here, it's a bomb.
It's really, really interesting. It's what's the time, it's what's the hype.
I can't imagine this turnout. It was never expected.
Wow, the energy is amazing.
I'm elated, I'm happy, I'm finally going.
It is very mad, we are leaving this school. Hey, I'm happy, I'm very, 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 very happy in this school. Woo!
Impacted on me positively, making me realize that you can't satisfy everybody, but still I still try as much as possible to satisfy some people, and there are a lot of things that come with that post, but it made me realize that there are different kind of people with different kind of character, and you should be able to try and understand people.
It hasn't been easy, to be very honest, being able to manage with students, try to accommodate them. But I have learned that regardless of whatever situation I find myself in, I should always be patient. So I have learned to be patient with students. It's ransom on the beat, baby.
dream. A dream so bravely tendered. 3 years of academic struggles. 3 semesters of working, praying, striving, failing, learning and surviving. That comes with life success. Gradually, our dreams have become our reality. Burning and shining towards our expected end. And the justification for our expected end is the amount of impacts we make through our career choices. Because making such choices is as fundamental as life in itself. For in the long run, who we are in the society will be traced to the choices we have made. So for the want of making purpose-driven choices, we have been provided with laudable, inexhaustible, passion-driven organizations and companies that can be instrumental in charting a good career course for us. Now, be wise, be swift, move on with the Phoenix Prowess, reinvent and recreate yourself with the undying desire to succeed, because you deserve to settle for nothing but the best.
It's that time of the year when the university justifies its claim of meeting industry needs by the caliber of graduates that it has produced and churned out. Great Phoenix class! Please give yourselves a big hand. Give yourselves a big hand. Thank you. Thank you very much. This has been put together by the Development and Strategy Office in conjunction or collaboration with the Phoenix Class of 2019. Very quickly, I would like to introduce the guests that we have here this morning. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to invite the companies and schools that are participating in this job fair to please greet this August gathering in no particular order now.
So I look forward to chatting and meeting a lot of the great minds that we have here at our stand later today. And it's always exciting to be among the young people and to tell them that they have a place in our space and talk to them, hear them. Because we have colleagues from BABCOCK and we're excited with what we have seen with them. So we look forward to talking to every one of you.
Thank you very much.
Under the revised pension scheme of 2014, there's a pension contributory scheme where each employee is meant to contribute a minimum of 18% from their monthly emolument. And we have our stands here, so feel free to come to us and we'll be happy to answer your questions and tell you about the opportunities available in the company.
Stambik IBTC, actually one of the organizations that in Nigeria that seems to recognize the importance of having talent, you know, in the organization. Talent that can move the company forward. And as such, we have a lot of graduates from BABCOCK University with us that have been very, very well. And most of them, we are giving them a celebrated promotion because of what they can offer for Stambik IBTC.
Would like to, you know, engage everybody here present, alumnus, students, everyone that approaches our stand will definitely be attended to.
We get a lot of BABCOCK graduates apply and they do well in interviews. So do not, literally speaking, fall your hands.
We've been partners with BABCOCK for about 4 years now. And we would like to say we are impressed with comments from clients about the BABCOCK graduates that we have trained. And we want to say we are proud of you and we look forward to having more of you.
Have a wonderful day.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we'll invite the one who steers the ship of this university to what it has become, the success and the excellence that it has become, Mr. President, Vice Chancellor, Professor Ademola Simintayo, for his address of welcome.
One of the unique selling points of BABCOCK University is what we are having today. It's an opportunity which I wish that we seize this moment and take it very seriously. These are the opportunities that we open for our students to connect, to be able to interact, to be able to hear, to listen, to interact, whether you want to go straight for higher degrees or whether you want to work. This week affords you the opportunity to interact with people. So once again, I want to welcome you. And on this note, I want to declare the job fair, the career fair and exhibition, open in the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Enjoy your week.
We would go straight to the next item on our program for this opening ceremony, and that's talking about the annual BABCOCK Alumni Best Business Plan Cash Award.
What is the parameter for choosing the best? Out of the people that have applied among our alumni, I want to say the process is extremely transparent. The master winner of the contest is Miss Akinbode Anna.
And the next thing we are going to have will be the photograph session, followed by the inspection of the various exhibition stands.
career week of graduating students roll together many activities, including experience, job fair, career week, and sporting activities. During this week, 1 week, which was declared lecture-free by Babcock University, all the students turned out in large mass. There were universities invited for students interested in pursuing their master's degree, and these students turned out and checked the programs that these universities had. There were companies invited, those who were prospecting job opportunities. So they had their booths also visited by the students. Some of these students who did very well at the mini, what I would call mock interviews, were given award and were recognized. This week also, we had the principal officers visiting us at the stadium to let the companies invited know that it's a university program. One of the experiences I had is that it gave me the opportunity to know in details the people I'd been working with right from the time I was appointed as the sponsor. There were two people who put everything together, Pastor Ikechi Ekwendu and Dr. Esther Ngozi Adejumo. These are wonderful people who tutored me about how to organize these students. And the executive themselves, I was able to know the qualities they were made of.
Has given me an opportunity to work with people. I have people, my team members, you tell them to do this and do that. Most of that, like, it has helped me to understand how people want to understand music and how they really, really have to understand music. It has really helped me a lot indeed.
Every learner is a potential achiever, but learning in isolation is not a sure way to achieving. Credible character development to a large extent guarantees effective achievement. Character cannot be developed in ease and quiet, but through experience can be strengthened and nurtured. One teaching method that can never be forgotten is the teaching from experience. Experienced minds arm us to be wary of imminent mistakes of life. It creates in us a first-hand sense of adventurous awareness. It is a veritable tool that shields us from failure. It keeps us standing before a fall, right before a run, and sails before a sink. So look in the mirror, experienced minds, and redefine yourself for good, as there can be no better teacher than experience. Welcome to the experience.
Just like the phoenix cluster across the southern skies, we were born to shine.
I've observed something. From 2005 to date, I've seen that Babcock University is dynamic in our way of adding value to students at all levels.
Today is another special day where people that have made name out there, people that have defined what our economy will be, people that have been successful in the world of work, you have them to share their experiences with you. So please listen carefully and the Lord will bless you abundantly. Thank you very much for listening.
I want to tell you the journey you are embarking on is not an easy journey, but the future is bright. And because the future is bright, you can believe that you are going to be someone great. But for you to be great, it requires two key things. Number one, it requires God. Number two, it requires you. So I wish you all well, and I pray that success will be in your domain.
The future can be what you want it to be. It all depends on you. You need to create value. People pay for value. If you don't have value, nobody's going to pay you good money. So you put the horse before the cart. Get the skills, get the experience, get the knowledge. Tell the person that this is what I can offer you. I bring this to the table. How much do you pay me? But don't demand for money. And then I say, so this money you want, what can you offer me? You say, well, I have a degree. It doesn't work that way. Don't see anything as a small thing. See it as an opportunity.
Life is a journey. And you need a compass to survive outside this world. Because the best compass that you have to survive outside this world are the materials, the mental, the cognitive advancement, your ability to accept a rude culture shock and be able to survive, that is the compass. you need to survive outside this world.
At the end of the activities for the career week, there was this sporting activities that organized two contestants from two departments, one from accounting, the second department was from computer science. They played their finals and a winner emerged at the end of the day. We had invited to that program, OGTV was at the sporting activities. Everything together, we could say, is the epicenter of the graduating class activities.
Well, basically, you know, BABCOCK is a learning environment, and then being the sport director, very challenging, but it's a task I went in for, and I think I impacted a little and I learned a lot also, because in sport, basically I play football, and now when you talk about sport, it's about everything about sport as far as BABCOCK University is concerned. So you have to go into the various parts of sports that you've never even gone into before. So it was challenging, and I have to learn also, and I have to give the little I can give. It's a lot of a lesson I learned.
Managing a win or a loss is one fundamental character that sporting activities embed in the mind of the dreamer. We learn and play by the rules, understanding the importance of the team, experiencing the fun of the reality, completion, and driving towards a common goal, the goal to win. Though various teams may appear, but a solid, unbreakable team we are, Team Phoenix. So at the end of the competition, there will be an array of emotions, riotous screams of victory, laughter and hugs, knuckle pumps and high fives in the victorious camp for a well-deserved victory. Every player played with one thing in mind. Every player made a match successful and has done the best possible. Some best are just more outstanding, but best is the best, and best always wins. The best we represent today, Phoenix Very Best.
Can he put Subban in front? Yes, he can! Dagot, he's done it again!
Oh, he
has the post. Here goes Pollitt, yes!
For his second.
Oh! It lays it off! And it's a hat-trick for Suarez!
I forecast it many weeks ago that they'll do this! I forecast they will be setting each other off penalty kicks! And what we have seen here is absolutely Shakespearean. The
Maya Wakatri, famously known as Latam. Anyway, so how does it feel to win?
It's actually very good because I've struggled all through the semester, training, injuries, tough things, but finally we got it. It was nice.
Was it a struggle? How was it? What was it like?
It's actually a tough struggle because all of us, they're retired. And then, you know, some of us just coming from home. And, like, some of us have exams, tough schedules, but we did well.
All right, there you have it. Maya Wakatri, one of our winners for today. Thank you. Okay, so with me, I have the goalkeeper, Tochi, and the coach. His name?
Udo.
Okay, so how does it feel to have led the team out and then you guys finally won and that you succeeded in not making them win, like your opponents and everything?
The tournament was tough, but we got all things are possible. I think the last penalty was luck. I tried my best.
There were doubts at first. Honestly, there were doubts. But all glory to God. We came out successful.
These people from my front of it.
BPSD, BABCOCK University, Professor Olaniyanju.
The trophy. See, tell this man he's crossing my camera.
He's crossing my line,
my friend.
Accounting team who came in second place. So how does it feel to have come in second place? This is their assistant captain.
Well, first of all, actually, we didn't come here for second place. We actually came here to win this game, and we let it slip through our fingers. But all I want to say is that it's a game of football, and kudos to Kenny, kudos to the entire computer science department. And one thing I want to say is that next year, Count is going to avenge this loss for us. And I want to tell all of you, cheers, Zlatan, thank you.
Okay, we've heard from him, and this is the captain going to talk now.
Yeah, as my assistant has just said, we're actually disappointed to come thus far and lose at the final. We actually went unbeaten throughout the whole competition. We didn't concede even up to today. So it's actually disappointing for me to lose in via penalties. But I have to say congrats to my teammates. I'm really proud of them. This is the first time accounting has come to the grad class finals. But we finished second place. So I believe that those that will be around next year, they'll take the team forward. But as I say, football is a game of, you need results. And the other team, they won the computer science. So I'll say congrats to them. Next year we'll get our chance, as my partner said, we'll avenge this loss. So thank you for everything.
Okay, so BCC has won the game, and accounting has put it to us here that we should never give up on anything and we should always encourage each other. The battle is not for us. We can always do what we want to do anytime, anywhere. Thank you.
An amazing experience so far. I mean, I've learned a lot as regards to my professional career and working with a team.
As we count down to our most anticipated day, we return from our various dwellings, all feasting together. Pleasant pictures from our pastimes appear to dwell in each other's hearts and each mind. Radiant beauties, impeccable handsomeness, beaming smiles, laughter and cheers, heavenly decors, flowing queenly gowns and accompanying princely suits and trads, and the tantalizing aroma of the mouth-watering delicacies, all for our one last night together. Now it is the time to dine, time to dance, and time to be merry. The rest is a bountiful bonus. Let us enjoy what we've got and also realize it is a lot. Bon appétit.
Tonight is electrifying. You can feel the excitement in the air. Everybody looking magnificent. 5 years is not easy, so I'm very excited to be here.
It is a really beautiful night. I get to see my friends and everybody really glowed up, and it's just really nice. I hope to have the best of time.
It feels so good to be here and to witness this.
It's a dream come true, so I'm happy to be here tonight.
Thank you.
is looking radiant.
Yeah, today is all good, so I'm grateful.
I really want to say thank you, Babcock University.
Father, this night we have nothing but just to praise you and to thank you.
I want to warmly welcome you to 2019 Undergraduate Banquet.
A special moment to give God the glory, to thank God for the mighty things he has done in our lives.
And it is already my testimony that by June 2, you will be fine, you will be excellent.
As I stand here today, I don't know any other person in this hall that is more happy than I am.
I just want to give God the glory for making me to have PhD. That's picking, husband, and a degree. Thank you very much.
I would have graduated last year, but in 2017, something happened to me that I had no control over.
I could not stop it, and I got suspended for that year. And I'm here today, and we're finishing with Babcock, so I'm thankful.
This is the time for prizes and awards.
Going on well, and I'm shocked to see a live band. It's really nice, like, it's really good to see.
On Thursday, we had the dinner, and it was really a social event. We could see the appreciation of the graduating class. They were so happy, you know, and all that. And there were several testimonies. I particularly remember that a student said she had PhD while here, and she's another graduate. She said she had Peking, she had husband, and she had a degree. She met her husband here, you know, and had all that while here. So, I mean, that's the kind of thing we do in Babcock, and we appreciate that. So other activities we also have, we have the consecration service. We want to dedicate our students before going, we want to empower them spiritually. We have the Sabbath school that will be coming up on Sabbath Saturday. We have the BABCOCK service on Saturday too.
There'll be a spiritual variety night on Saturday, and then on Sunday, expected convocation program itself. And so far, so good. We know that things will work out well. We're able to do some project dedication. We had a project at Iberu Campus. We had the gazebo. We had the mini stadium. We also had the amphitheater, trying to leave a legacy behind for those who are coming after us.
With smiles and some with tears.
It's a long shot from the sea. It begins of struggles, did not look like we will make it. I spied a long
plant this tree in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
And the shovel.
Yeah, the shovel. Look at the camera.
Amen.
Don't let the tree cover your face.
What is the name of this tree?
The Father and the Son.
In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
You know you were originally a farmer.
No, the nylon is there.
Look at it.
We planted in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Well, I must say that even though I wanted to run for the post, for the office rather, I didn't really know the integrities of the post. But when I got in, I didn't know that I have two parties to play for both monumental projects and compulsory projects. But when I got into the place, I had to learn certain things like resilience, things like hard work, things like diligence, especially patience, because I have to work with resources. And not only financial resources, but also human resources.
I want to stand on existing protocol.
And they are strong enough to hold you.
Very strong enough to hold you. Thank you, sir. Well, from the inception of the Phoenix class, Iberu Campus said we must do something for them. That in past times, no graduating class has made them happy. So this is the project.
Sufficiently happy.
And she made sure we did things here. This, the gazebos then, yeah, they were not really, you know, they were falling apart. So we decided to repair them. And we also gave them seats for their stadium. To just a mini stadium. So we thank God for his mercies, for seeing us through.
Yeah, today, on behalf of the governing council of the university, I cut this step in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And of the Son,
amen,
and of the Holy Spirit.
We cut this ribbon to the glory of the Lord and blessings of the task of the name of the Father,
amen,
of the Son, of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
to the glory of Almighty God and service of humanity, in the name of the Father, Amen. Of the Son, Amen. And of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Time like this now that rain is falling, this place without this would not have been in use. So we thank God for his mercies, for seeing us through. It was actually almost, we're scared at a point that this would be done in time, but we thank God for his mercies. I believe this is a befitting legacy that the Phoenix class is leaving behind, and on that note I believe we can commission this project.
Yes, first. So, Pastor.
Yeah. Father, we like to thank you for what you are doing and what you have done and what you will do. We like to hand over this project to you. Lead out, O Lord, so that it will be fully completed.
Amen.
To your glory and honor. In the name of the Father, Amen. And of the Son, Amen. And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Well, to the glory of the Lord and for the service of mankind, I commissioned this building in cutting the ribbon today in the name of the Father, Amen. The Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
After 4 years here, I would say that I've gained a whole lot, not only in the side of the academics. I mean, BABCOCK teaches us mental, physical, social, and the spiritual part of it. And I believe that I've had a bit of before. And one of the places that I've gotten is my mental development. Because mental development fuels your social life. And when it comes to social life, then you can have spaces for these leadership advantages that I've had. And this is not my first attempt in leadership, but this is like the peak of it, and I must say that if not for BABCOCK, I will not be given this opportunity to serve and to deliver my own quota to students. And having all this met in my university days, that means that when I leave here, I'm at a greater advantage to actually handle resources, because if I can handle this even as a student, when I'm off the school environment and when I'm working, I will have a larger experience to deliver. And when I can deliver the oldest point back to where did you school, BABCOCK.
It has taught me to think out of the box, take responsibility of other people's actions and wrong decisions because I'm the person in charge of it. It has taught me to be fast and quick with everything I'm doing.
Well, I must say it has been a wonderful experience working as a chaplain for the class. And then it has impacted me in so many ways, but let me just divide them in two ways. One, it has impacted me, like it has given me that I've had an experience working with students and also with God, in the sense that having worked as someone who's going to carry the burden of the class, you know, being in charge of the chapel seminar cards and everything, so you want to bear the responsibility of their cards, you know, presenting them before the school, so like bearing the whole burden together, and also you have one or two people who will come around to say, I have this problem, and so you want to cancel from the Bible and also have that prayer. And so that will also give me a wonderful experience with God. Like I said, it's going to be in two ways. With God, like, I would always have that opportunity where I speak to God about someone or about the responsibilities of the escorts or the entire class, and as a matter of fact. So it has been a really, it has indeed been a wonderful experience working as the chaplain.
Thank you for all the stories and all the testimonies and the wonderful experiences that have led to this moment. We thank you for the parents who are here, the supporters, for the administrators, faculty, staff, but most of all, Lord, we thank you for the graduating class of 2019.
So we want to recognize our Almighty God, first and foremost, for his leading in our lives. I'm going to start now to begin the introduction.
We want to thank you for doing your best to keep BABCOCK according to the goal of this institution.
We say thank you to our parents for having confidence in the proprietor of BABCOCK University. Graduating class of this year is favored.
It is now time to worship God in giving.
Second Corinthians chapter 1, reading beginning at verse 3 to verse 5.
Delva W. Baker, PhD, is currently the Vice Chancellor of the Adventist University of Africa, AUA, in Nairobi, Kenya.
My message is entitled The Babcock Band of Comforters. I want this to be a memorable sermon. And so I declare unto you that God called you 4 years, 5 years, 6 years, however many years ago, He called you to Babcock with a special message and a special purpose for you. If you believe that, graduates, say amen. We leave this place refreshed, revived, and determined to follow in your footsteps.
In the name of Jesus Christ, let everyone say,
amen.
Amen. Amen.
Our joy will be incomplete if this day passes by unnoticed. So our minds turn into what time taught us, what we have learned, and who we have become. In each of our days, we find many blessings, but most times we overlook them. Choosing rather to focus on negatives, today is the moment of appreciation and obeisance to the one who made all this to be. We are thankful for life, for today, and thankful for making our tomorrow brighter than our vision. With your guidance from above, we have so much more. So let us add up our blessings and make Thanksgiving last more than just today. Thank you, Father in heaven. And thank you, Babcock.
It actually feels like my life has started, basically, because I've been waiting for this. Like, I was supposed to graduate, but I had a bit of difficulty, and it just feels like, okay, yes, it's possible, because it felt so impossible last year.
Yes, I feel elated. I feel happy. After 4 years in school, finally, I'm leaving school, so I feel very, very happy.
I feel thankful that in a few days I'll be convocating.
It's a very great moment to leave the school at exact time you're meant to leave, exactly 4 years. It's a thing of joy. Like, it's not everybody that came here with me that are finishing with me. So it's a thing of joy. I'm very happy, and I thank God for everything, for His grace and mercy throughout these 4 years.
Today is our Thanksgiving, and I feel very happy.
after 5 years in accounting. Today is a day of joy. We're looking forward to tomorrow. We're hoping to God that everything goes well.
I feel so grateful to God for this moment. Being in BABCOCK for 4 years is not the easiest thing to do, and being here today is like, just like you're reaping the fruit of your labor, and I feel so happy. I'm very, 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 very glorious. More than my face can even show.
Okay, I'm happy and I'm grateful to God for keeping us up to this time and His thanksgiving time, and we just have to give all praises to God for everything He has done for us.
I'm so excited because Thanksgiving means that it's literally a day to graduation, and I'm just so grateful to God for the 4 years that I have spent here and how good it has been.
Phoenix Clubson actually came about as a result of the fact that we have seen ourselves as stars.
Isaiah chapter 40 verse 31 assures us that even when it seems like all strength is lost, like the phoenix bird, God will renew our strength and enable us to fly with wings and shine with grace.
And now, what seemed like forever, like the cliché, every beginning has an end, soon winds to its victorious and much anticipated finishing, having received a kind of education that defines the norm, and what could be more than to announce our majestic exit from such place as BABCOCK University, leaving a print of our washed feet on the sand that has redefined us over time in a very peculiar way, leaving its indelible trace of morality and godliness. We are prepared, ready to build and reinvent the world for good.
begin this program today, O Lord, we begin in your name. We pray, O God, let your glory overwhelm and envelop this arena.
I humbly invite the Chancellor to substitute this assembly.
I am able to constitute this assembly as the congregation of BABCOCK University, Elishan Remo Ogun State, and declares this convocation ceremony open for the purpose of conferring first degree, higher degree, and for the presentation of prizes.
Today, we have with us 1,925 undergraduates that will confer their respective degrees today. And 372 of these at the postgraduate level, of which 62 undergraduates made the first class division. You are the reason why we are here today, having endured and pushed through to the end. Now you see the silver lining behind the clouds. To my dear graduating students, I say congratulations.
Professor Toyin Falola is a Nigerian historian and professor of African studies, renowned for his historiography in Africa. He is the Jacob and Francis Sanga Mosika Chair in the Humanities and Distinguished Teaching Professor at the University of Texas at Austin.
Most important people here today are the students and their parents. Congratulations, great students.
I respectfully call upon the Deputy Vice Chancellor Academics for conferment of first degrees and awards.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, these persons who are being presented have fulfilled the requirements of the statutes and regulations of the university. I have been found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be admitted to the degrees of their respective schools.
Let them face life realistically and find contentment with God in whatever things they do.
I remember when I came here 4 years ago, the management staff attended to me. I still relive those moments of how courteous they were. And it was one of the things that made me just decide that my daughter should come here.
The best graduating student with the highest CGPA undergraduate is Bawadogo Edafe. From education.
For me today, it's a fulfillment of God's promise. I believe God had a plan and I was just a part of it. And for me, I'm grateful. For the future, I know that he who has begun a good work, he who brought me this far, has a purpose and he will fulfill it in Jesus' name.
For masters, we have Oluwadara Deborah Eboluwa. For PhD, we have from mass communication, Chode Inde Oluwaseyi Adewumi.
I feel elated, I'm excited, I'm happy. I just want to bless the name of the Lord.
In all my years here in BABCOCK, I haven't had to look too far for inspiration. We each have the potential to make an inspiring contribution to others by being true to our values. If they ever tell my story, let them say I walked with giants. Names rise and fall like the winter wheat, but this name will never die. Let them see I graduated with the Phoenix class and I was shining with grace.
There are a lot of plans, but God's will is always the best.
This day marks the beginning of a journey of sorts. The story of our lives will not be complete without a mention of Babcock University.
At this time, we want to appreciate some of our special guests today. We want to appreciate everybody here, the press crew, the friends, guests of the university. Thank you for honoring our invitation. Till I see you again, the Lord bless you and keep you safe.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. I hereby finally declare the convocation ceremony to close in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. May God bless you.
It's a long shot from here to say, but we went in the max, headed for the finish line. Days passed us by, left us with smiles and some with tears.
It's a long shot.
It marks the end of my Babcock chapter as an undergraduate student and the beginning of my future.
But I really thank God that I'm alive to see this day.
Happy I'm graduating, to be very honest.
It's truly a blessing to be surrounded by these few people that we have here.
It's June 2, we are graduating.
I just give glory to God for every single thing.
It's really a great privilege to be amongst those graduating today, especially when you get to do your master's.
I really appreciate the school for giving us this kind of opportunity.
I wish everyone that's graduating the best of luck in all their endeavors.
It's a step to higher ground, I know.
I'm only looking forward to great things ahead.
I'm happy to be a member of the Phoenix graduating class.
My prayer that with God Almighty will bless us all with Jesus' name.
Being part of the Phoenix graduating class, I'm so happy today.
I'm so happy and I'm thankful to God.
It's been God all the way.
I'm really excited because I'm graduating at 19.
I feel excited, I feel happy, and I feel proud of myself.
I'm just so happy about being a graduate and coming out of Babcock.
It's over, we're excited.
It's been a great experience here in Babcock.
We love Babcock.
We love Babcock and discover Babcock.